Hello, this is Papa Frank. Welcome to my channel. Today it's all about tie rods, MR2 tie rods. When it comes to these tie rods, there is definitely a lot more than meets the eye. These are the rear tie rods from a Toyota MR2. This is from a 1993 or later car, and this is from a 91 or 92 car, and they are different lengths and different construction. I don't want to get into the whys and wherefores of Toyota making this change. Hint, snap oversteer, okay? The fact is that the longer tie rod reduces the bump steer. What, you say? Bump steer on the rear wheels? How can that be? Yes, bump steer on the rear wheels. Get over it. Besides the lens, there are some other differences between the 91, 92 and the 93 and later. The later tie rod is much beefier. The diameter is bigger, and this applies both to the straight areas and the threaded areas. The diameter on this newer tie rod on the threaded area is like, 18 millimeter? Is it something else? 18. And the diameter on the older tie rod . There we go. 14. Pitch for both is 1.5. Okay, so 18 by 1.5 and 14 by 1.5. And I don't know what you would need this information for. Nudge, nudge, wink, wink. The difference in effective length between these two tie rods is about 4 inches. The effective length on this is about 18 inches, and on this is about 14. So that's about like a 10 centimeter, nice metric number. You'll notice that these tie rods have no flats anywhere. Most tie rods you'll see have flats, but these do not have flats. And we'll talk about why that is in a minute. Let's look at how you make a length adjustment on this tie rod, assuming this end with the joint is in the cross member and this end is in the knuckle. The length is adjusted by rotating the turnbuckle. And the turnbuckle is rotating very easily, as you can see. And one end is right hand thread, the other end is left hand thread. So when you rotate the turnbuckle one way, it pushes both ends out, and you rotate it the other way, it pulls both ends in. Now I'll bet you dollars to donuts, when you take your car in an alignment shop, they're going to tell you that these tie rods are seized and they cannot be rotated. How do I know that? I know that because most techs who work in shops these days do not know about the secret locking mechanism that Toyota put into these tie rods. What? The secret locking mechanism? What are you talking about, Papa Frank? Let me show you. I showed you how you can rotate the turnbuckle very easily with hardly any resistance. And while I was doing that, I was keeping both ends in very precise alignment. Now what happens if I just try to turn one end? The tie rod locks. What happens if I try to turn the other end? the tie rod locks, okay? And for a tech who's not familiar with this, when they see that this tie rod is locking, they will just assume that it is seized and no good. All right, so let's look at the locking mechanism. To look at the locking mechanism, we have to undo the tie rod entirely, all the way. So now if you look here, the threads don't just end with a flat end, there's a tongue that sticks out from the end of the threaded area. And the tongue from each end fits precisely over the tongue from the other end. So when you go to turn these against one another, they are going to lock, because the tongue on one end will prevent the rotation of the tongue on the other end. And that will make it seem like the tie rod is seized. Now this is complicated when you have a rusty old tie rod, and it's all genuinely seized with a lot of resistance to rotation. This is hard enough to do when we've already disassembled this and cleaned it and put it back together. And if it's a old rusty tie rod, it's like 10 times harder to do this. If you have one of these guys that just does not want to come free because the ends are locked up and they do not want to turn relative to one another, like, okay, they just come to a point where they do not want to turn, you have to maintain the relative orientation of the ends. And you may have to just turn this by one fraction of a turn at a time. So using some bars, just turn the top end, then follow suit with the lower end, then turn the top end another fraction of a turn, follow with the lower end, and as long as you keep doing that, you'll be able to unfasten this just going by one fraction of a turn at a time. So here's the proper way to reassemble this tie rod. First, we make sure that the two ends are in the proper orientation where they key together. Then we take the turnbuckle and we just get these started. There we go. There, they have just locked. When the two ends come together, they give you the illusion that the tie rod cannot be turned. But if you just turn one of them relative to the other a little bit, turn one end relative to the other a little bit, turn this end, this unlocks them. If you turn the end back the other way, it locks right up. There's no way to turn it. But if you turn it back, then you unlock it. There, unlocked again. That covers how to reassemble them, how to disassemble them. The key is to be aware of this locking feature. So I hope this helps you with your quest for fun with tie rods, and thanks for watching.